The purpose of the Keshe Foundation technology development is very simple. We are not to allow our knowledge to be peer-reviewed by a few privileged. We put our knowledge on the internet to be peer-reviewed by every man, and every man takes up from it according to its own level of understanding and no more. And at the same time, there are a lot of people, somebody's taking a picture at the back. Hello, are you taking a video? Ah, it's okay. She's got a laptop facing me. So what it is, we want to share knowledge in a free way. And the free way is, I give my knowledge to you totally free. And this new knowledge, according to the governments who now I'm negotiating with, is so radical that they want to see the change through. We are not here to take bribe, and we are not here to do backhanders. Keshe Foundation is financially independent, so nobody can dictate to us. And secondly, Keshe Foundation is there to make sure the next generation does not get to the same dilemma as today as we are. You will understand, for the first time we show in the video coming up, literally what was Tesla's dream, but is a reality to us. And once we conclude our position with the government, this is in the hand of every one of you. Look at the introduction video, which is already on the net for nearly 2 weeks, and it's past 300,000 or so, I've been told, viewing. And in China has passed couple of millions. This video tells you exactly who we are, what we do, and then I'll try to explain to you the first part of the teaching. You lot want the generator tomorrow, but none of you knows what's the knowledge behind it. So we start teaching you the knowledge, and if you missed it this morning, the one who haven't been here, we hand over the space and energy technology to public on 14th of December in Belgium. The arrangement has kicked into process this morning, and our guest is the sixth man who has landed on the moon as an astronaut. So he has accepted our offer, and this morning we received the confirmation. Now we can announce it, because they knew we wanted to announce it today, so they made their best job to do it. So what is, again, that part on the 14th is the same as today. We hand over the old technology, we listen to the man who's been on the moon, it's a dream of all of us, and we show how all of us can do it in a much shorter time with the new technology. The 7th of November presentation will be on the medical side. So we go the same way. As an article said somewhere on the internet in America, by refusal of President Obama of the Keshe technology, America should soon be a third world nation compared to Africa. The African nations, ambassadors who were here the last meeting, they already have started the battle who's going to be the center for Keshe Foundation. So much so that on the day and the day after of the 6th of September, the Sudan president with their ambassador and their expert here in the room announced for the first African space agency, because that's what we asked for it. And within short time, already been announced in Guardian newspaper, in the African government meeting, the motion has already been put into act. And we are getting approached by different African nations and South American nations for them to be the center for the space technology. So on the 12th of October, I fly to Sierra Leone, and I give lectures and direct teaching to the scientists in Africa, and there are different scientists flying all over from Africa to learn, and they will be taught. The transfer of technology and knowledge is absolutely free, so the governments get the whole lot in one go. So what does this mean? This means my knowledge is yours, Keshe Foundation belongs to you. A lot of you come from all over the world to be here today, to go to Keshe Foundation. But in fact, you should have said, I'm going home. This is your home, but this is a home of knowledge, not the home to sleep in. In reality, we give you the knowledge, it's yours to take it back. And so many of you ask me, can you come to my country? Your country is my country. So you organize it, I come and teach you what I did with Iran. I spent 4.5 months in Tehran, I transferred full knowledge on the space technology, and we all know what happened last December. Technology is complete, and soon, the problem with me is every time I say soon, the Iranians do faster things than I say. But soon, the space technology landing outside the space of Earth will be shown in full operation. Last time we showed the reactor on the 3rd, within a couple of days, the American plane was captured and said they're going to show the power of the technology. We showed the capturing method on a video 2009 to Boeing and American government, this is what's going to happen. The video is a live video and it shows I'm much younger, it's not a fresh one. We explain how the technology is and what the jamming system is, and now it's being used. So, if people ask us, can you give us a proof, go and speak to the Iranian government. On the other hand, go and ask the people who've been helped by the medical side. Go and ask, we have got somebody here, I don't see him. Oh, he's there in the back. We are running trials on the seeds. And Mr. Gee is handling it independently with in conjunction with scientists here. We see the change. He was just showing me a picture of one seed usually gives one stem. But now one seed gives what? 6-7 stems. So it means the foliage, the food for animals in Africa, can be sorted in a very easy way. You have 7-10 times more harvest. So it's not that we don't give you your energy, and all of you are here for energy. Energy to us is absolutely, totally irrelevant. It's a byproduct. It's a fallout from the technology transfer. My objection or my target is to take man into space the correct way, the safe way, and for everybody. At the moment, a space is for all of us. As long as we have 20 million, we can pay to the Russians, half the profit goes to the Americans. We're going to get trained for several years, at least 6 months to 12 months, to be in the space for a few seconds or a couple of days. A space technology in the hand of the Iranian government is open to you. You can go to space tomorrow morning, exactly the way you get on the jump plane and you came here. You can get the same trip back. The reason is very simple. I always hide things. It's the easiest way. I decided to give this to you. Unless you hold it, you don't know what it is. One for you, you're a professor. You can explain to us. One is a small one as well. Share it among yourself. That's how the knowledge is going to be shared. Take 4 and give back one or more. That's all. Or take 2, give back to the back, and do the same. We share, give me 4, I need 4. The rest is yours. This is the simplicity of knowledge to share. I'm going to push this out of the way. All you need to do, take 4 and pass it, keep 4 big ones or 2 big ones and 1 small one and let the other people at the back see. This is how we share knowledge from now on. I know, you know. This is how we do on our internet. Just take your rings and open them. And if you can open them, try to place them in the ring. You have to twist it. If you get this effect, you're in the right direction. This is the new space technology which all of you are holding in your hand. Till you don't hold it in your hand, you don't know what knowledge you carry. And when you hold it in your hand, you know that we know this knowledge from time of our birth. But through commercial pressure and our ancestors' development in over a short time, we never looked at it. We never bothered to understand it. So what I want you to do, the easy way, is if you look, if you understand this structure, you understand everything we do in Keshe Foundation. It can be stopped now. Whoever has it, whoever not, we gotta stop. Because otherwise it's gonna be a whole day. If you make a ring, this is how you are going to travel into space. At the moment, we load up tons of fuel. Can we stop, please, Caroline? Hello? My wife is usually the worst one. Sit down. There. Because she tries to make sure everybody understands. This is very simple. If you take one of the small, big one and one small one, and you look, all you have to do is very simple. You use no fuel. You cover the huge gap. Time of burning fuel is finished. That's the simplicity of it. In the universe, we never see long objects. We always see spherical objects because of the motion and central gravity within the structure. As I always say, is quantity in the entity. If you put more of it, you have a bigger ring. If you put less of the same thing, you have a smaller ring. Call this electron, call this proton. Call this the sun, call this the earth. Make it larger. Go to a galaxy. Yes. No, we don't. Congratulations. It's not so small, but it's the same thing, isn't it? Sounds bigger. No, but we're talking about proportion. No problem. So, what happens is very simple. If you can create gravitational magnetic field of your destination, travel is nothing. There is no fuel burned. But it's learning the process of opening the plasma to use its magnetic field. So, if you put your three systems together, very simply, they tell me I'm crazy because it damages a lot of PhDs. Believe you me, I know. So, if you take your small magnet and just bring it to the other two, you see it moves. You don't need to create motion. You just need to create a right magnetic gravitational field strength. You want to go to the moon, you create gravitational magnetic field of the moon, because moon does not have a gravity alone. It has a gravity and magnetic field. Earth has gravity and magnetic field. The two together dictate the position of one in respect to the other one. Exactly what it is. The gravity, we call it attraction. This is gravity, when the two attract. This is repulsion. You try to get this to the other one, it doesn't allow. When the gravitational magnetic field of this, which is entry and exit flow of the magnetic field, are in balance with that and that, then it dictates its position. Now, this could be the Earth, this could be the Sun, this could be electron, it could be a proton. So, now we have developed a technology, what we call a plasma technology. We can open the plasma. And by doing so, we find we do not need to burn any fuel to find position. The positioning comes by itself. That's how our cells, our atoms of our body, molecules of our body, the sun, the earth, galaxies find a position. There is no driver and there is no wings and no planet. And there is no jet engines on any of them, but they find their position. So, this is where the change comes, and the reality comes when I sit and listen to a lot of scientists talking about scalar waves, transfer magnetic field, is because they got used to looking at one thing. You have to look at two. This object will not hold its position if the entry and the exit of the other one's magnetic flow could not be in balance. if you bring them together, if you put two entries, it's like very much like a traffic jam. They can't get in. They push each other's separation. If you bring enough cars that flow fluently through a tunnel, is attraction, gravity. You put the two together, you always have a dynamic plasma. So the knowledge we brought is very simple. How plasmas work, how they are created. In the book number one, I explain the structure of the plasma. In the book number two, I explain how plasma moves from one position to another. We call it light. And in the third book, I explain how plasmas find position in respect to each other. Because, as I always say, is a quantity in the entity. A drop of water has no different characteristics as a glass of water, has no different characteristics and property than an ocean of water. It's the quantity in the entity. So, if you understand that, you play game of gods. The simplicity of it is, if you have a two magnets, if you got with your magnets you can play, then you understand it. Try to very simply bring your two magnets together where they cannot, you find them, they slip against each other. This slippage, this point, this is the magnetosphere of this in respect to this. That's the border. Somewhere in between is the magnetosphere. You turn it. That's the gravitation of it. So when you have two dynamic plasmas, you have two gravities and two magnetic fields, four forces, which work with each other to find their position each other. So they move along into and from one point to another. So, in fact, what happens is that, very simply, you are a nuclear physicist without past 5 minutes than all the physicists in CERN laboratory, because they are looking for God's particle. What is God particle? God particle is you and me. You've listened to my interviews recently. When a higher order, a strength magnetic field, goes down in a strength that it becomes tangible to any entity, could be a human being, then it's a matter. So all of us have become visible. So we are all God's particle. That's the simplicity of it. So in fact, if you have a source, this source radiates its magnetic field out, and from where it leaks out or comes out to the point when it becomes physically apparent, you have a source, you have a gap, and you have matter. So the source, you call it the sun. The gap, you call it the space between the Earth and the sun. And Earth is where that magnetic field has slowed down enough that it becomes tangible to us, visible to us. So the process is simple. There is no difference in any levels of creation. Proton has the same property, electron has the same property. The solar system is a plasma, Earth is a plasma on its own, and it goes to the universe and galaxies. So this is how simple the new knowledge is. And we have put it in a pattern, and we use the blocking system of the nations to actually release our pattern. We put a pattern in, we paid for it, they published it, we withdrew it, so it's in public. Nobody can ever apply for discovery and application of, which is some few hundred applications plus thousands of applications within the patents. We have a very cunning pattern writer. The gentleman sitting there, he writes pattern in a way that the patent office gets confused, so they don't know what to do with it. So we've been, believe it or not, we are the only organization, a lot of you, we start letting you know what's happening. We are the only organization which our patent, we have to take it to Den Haag. We cannot deliver it to the National Patent Office, because they say all our patent has to be delivered. We drive all the time to Den Haag, We give our patent and that's it, nobody sees it. Yeah? Because they don't even trust the Belgian patent office, because they might not get the whole lot of it to them. So we are very easy to understand in a way of, you call it antimatter, we call it principal matter. The other name for it is a star. The other name for it is a black hole, depends on what quantity and portion you look at it. The point when the magnetic field goes from one point to another, because there is no interaction between the fields, there is hardly any light, because light creates from the interaction of magnetic field. We like it, we call it a dark matter, dark energy, but in fact it's the same energy which is coming from the sun with a higher strength till they get to us, and then it appears as a matter. So this is a plasma. A lot of physicists don't like this because it gives them, they have to give a lot of their PhDs back. Pardon? Pardon? You see dark matter in the dark night, yes. It's very easy. Every day. So, in a way, electron and proton is a division. So, as we say, an electron, a plasma, when it divides, what we call a nuclear decay, if you call this one neutron, this plasma, it decays to electron and a proton. As my colleague Dirk Loresen said, if you ask scientists what is electron, they tell you we don't know, but electron, as I always say, if I split this glass of water in two halves, or 10 halves, or one half of a big and a small one, what is the small one? It's still a water. So, in reality, plasma of electron, electron is a plasma, and then it comes to what this plasma does. Look at this, this is done by NASA. Look at the date on the side. This is a sun with its twin star. This is one star with its twin star. Twinity is principle of conservation of magnetic fields. Twinity is the principle of conservation of magnetic field. And how you play the twinity gives you a different thing. This is a twinity. The proportion dictates the speed and the rest of what you understand. If you turn it, oh, people won't take a picture. So, in fact, the twinity is what Tesla understood. And if you look at this, this is a twinity in a simple version. But you have to develop it to understand it. We see twin galaxies. This is from NASA. You see the connection in so many ways. Just about, if I ever learn to use this. You see this line here? This is a magnetic dust. So, twinity is not exclusivity of electron and a proton, or stars, it's galaxies. And surely we have twinity universes, but it's beyond our understanding at this moment of time. You have twin stars. How do they become twin? Why do they need to become twin? How the twinity comes? You have magnetic field. The south pole of one has to connect with north pole of the other one, and the north pole of the other one has connect to the other one. Change the terminology, physics become very interesting. Just change it. Call it entry pole and exit pole. what magnetic field comes out of one pole, which is the exit pole, has to go somewhere. It finds its path through its twin. And that's the simplicity of it. Now they call it one wave and another. The two scientists and all the formulas we watched this afternoon, speaking, one they did the other half and the other one did the other half, which one is correct? One has measured this one, and the other one has measured that one. And they both claim they're right. They're right. So this solves the mystery of listening for us this morning. Both scientists are right. Because one is measuring one node to South Pole, and one measures one node to North Pole. Magnetic field do not move unless there is a gradient differential. Depends where you sit in it. And then you can dictate what you want out of it. It's a very simple process. You put your entry, you put the rest, and then you decide where in the center you're going to sit. If you sit here near the bigger brother, you can absorb more of the field, what's on the motion. Redefine energy, then it's become very easy. In the principle of twinity, the ratio, the shape, the structure, the size and the amount of different strength magnetic field content of the entity dictate the position and the speed of rotation of the twins in respect to each other. Professor Miles explained to you earlier on that the same thing, but in a scientific way. I'm an engineer, he's a mathematician. So they say if one is increasing, the other one, that's why I especially asked that question for him to clarify it. So proton is bigger, electron is smaller, the distance and the amount of magnetic gravitational field inside them dictates the speed. Addition to it is the position in respect to each other decides if the electron goes clockwise or anti-clockwise. In the new book which is coming out with Mr. Lorenzen's doing the, what do you call it, the pictures for it, we explain how Venus is going clockwise, because it's just to do with its position in respect to the Sun. It has still, it's got that rotation. No meteorite has ever hit it, I explained it in the new book, and it's the same why Uranus goes on its vertical axis. It's all to do with the quantity, position of magnetic fields in respect to each other. A lot of people say we have the four seasons on Earth because of our tilted degree. If you understand and run reactors the way I do, you understand we are on the process of a vibration to take the position of Venus. The angle comes, the system goes violent, it shakes everything off itself, and because it moves to a new position, it will go clockwise. There is no difference in the world of creation. This is all explained in the new book. You have the rain, which comes from Earth with the rainwater, steam goes up, cools down, rains back down, we have a rain. The same process happens in the world of plasma of a solar system. The material goes up, the gravitational center pulls, you call it Saturn, whatever. Because we have such a short life, we think they're always in that position. But as they lose their gravitational magnetic field strength, they get attracted by the stronger pole, which is the Sun, which is 85-90% of the total mass. So we are just thinking we are forever here. Very soon we go back to Mother and we rain back on in different form in the next few billion years. So you understand how we come and how the things happen. It says, fundamental principle of thought, the speed of rotation of the plasma of electron is dictated by amount of magnetic field which are transferred from the large twin plasma of the proton to the plasma of smaller twin plasma of the electron. So, for the first time, you understand a lot of things about the behavior of the plasma of electron. But if you ask me, how do I know these things? I have several reactors, I can mimic the condition. I was talking to somebody very recently, he said, you have a very sophisticated lab. You built yourself a very good one. Huh? So, to see this, you have to understand. Then, you have to be very simple. Put something between the two. If you move it to the bigger part, you absorb a bigger energy. If you move it to the smaller part, you absorb less of. But depends where the cross point is. So, in reality, a lot of people tell me, we didn't make that. That's a picture of one of the reactors we built and it's been tested. Built in Bruges, material cut for us in Holland, and assembled here in Belgium. We spend a lot of money doing it, and it's very nice how it operates. We learned a lot from this. So, in a way, now, all you do, replace the big sun with the small one and make your reactor to be the new sun, the smaller brother. You see what happened? Things don't change. Now, we have the knowledge to create plasma within this reactor to behave as any other entity in the universe. Has gravity, has magnetic field, and in a simple way, it becomes part of the setup. So, you see what happens. You have a sun, you put a reactor in the middle somewhere, and then you have the Earth. The polarity, one has to come, one to go. Not all the fields of the sun will go through the reactor, but what is needed. As Professor Maher said to us earlier, depends what is in the environment. You want more energy on Earth, you move your reactor further closer. You want the other way, you do it the other way. So, this is what we call SVS system. This is the space power supply system. This system will be operational within a matter of few months. You ask us, where is our energy unit? Two reasons. If we put this reactor on the planet, governments will have control over it. These systems will stay. This is the first time we announced this, about five months. If you've been to my lectures, I speak about, if you have a double mobile, you can have everything you like. The people who have been to my lectures, they know what I'm talking about. Through this system, this is dream of Tesla in so many ways. But he needed as Professor Maher told us, he needed a power plant, oil. He needed something to create that energy that he could transmit. Now we have the plasma technology knowledge, we sit in the plasma of the universe. And because our fields, very much like these poles, are matching, we can transmit to any position on Earth. You can pick energy anywhere within the solar system and beyond, and you don't need to burn anything. All you need to do is to be able to pass, hold, and create the same amount of energy. You're in the South Pole, in the North Pole, you have a party, it's a Christmas, everybody New Year celebrates, the whole world can have as much as they like at the same time. These systems are on trial now, and the latest one we will show on the 14th. You will see a full display of the energy transfer through plasma. You don't need connections. The plasma stands up. Oh, sorry. The plasma holds its position, and in holding its position, it'll transfer its energy to three or four more at the same time. This is not a dream, this is a practicality. I tried to have it ready for today, but it was impossible. Secondly, I have to inform you, we cannot show anything in Belgium. Our material, nuclear material, is under confiscation of the federal and nuclear atomic authorities of Belgium and the police. So, and we've been fighting since last November to get our license. I've been told in a meeting 2 weeks ago, the license is questionable after 10 months. And interesting enough, the gentleman who makes the decision about my license, he's the same gentleman who authorized, he knew and allowed the nuclear reactors in Belgium with a crack to go into operation 20 years ago. The wolf has become the keeper of the nest. So we'll see what happens in that position. So the man who's putting the whole nation in danger, he tells me I cannot have a small reactor which I can run my business. And I'm very safe. They checked everything correctly. 6-7 years of running reactors in Belgium, they could not find any contamination, no radiation, nothing, and they brought the latest machinery into my lab. So, we'll see what the position will be, but I'm sure 2-3 governments soon will put these satellites, what we call SVS in satellite, in orbit, and all of you can have as much energy as you like. but you start paying for it. Not because the magnetic field comes free from the space, because you want to keep the structure of your society. You want to be safe, you want to have your water and everything else. And as I always say, and this is a discussion I had with African nation ambassadors and the governments in past 3 weeks, is that everyone will have access to clean water, energy as much as possible, and to build one of these reactors. At the moment, a full operational is just about $35 to $40. We are that advanced. So we are not dreaming. As you see, this is not a dream, it's an actual metal. Some of you who came to the presentation of the 3rd of December last year, you've seen it, it was shown. Now we show its purpose of it. So, in fact, all you need to do, if you understand the structure, increase the twinities and go further, and even go further. I'll give you time to take pictures. Sorry, I'm a bit too fast for you. And if you go still with the same twinity further, this you get a structure of what we call nanomaterials. Nanolayers are exactly the same structure as the universe. This is what the nanoscientists don't understand, and what we put out about 2005 to IMEC. IMEC is the leading nanotechnology office in Belgium or in the world, 200 million business. They checked it, we gave the material to the Diamond Bourse in Belgium, they checked it, and nanomaterials, nanolayers operate as material gap, but even the gap has a gravitational center. So it has its own pooling area, it's like a black hole. It's not that it's empty. So what you get, you have very much a superconductor. That's why nanomaterials on layers are. Nobody knew this. We put this pattern in 2006, 2007. All the claims are in there. So what happened? When a field comes in, if I go as slowly as possible, you can take. Please distribute this knowledge as much as you can through internet and anywhere else till we put it up. There is no blockage. Nobody can stop you. So as the ray comes in, don't forget, every gap, every hole has its own gravitational magnetic field. Each one is a star. Each one is a planet. The ray has to give some and take some. And as it goes through, because it has a higher speed and higher magnetic field, it loses some of it to the nearest ones. This could be, I call it the electron and the proton from a hydrogen, a metal, a copper or whatever. Nothing changes, it's the same process. So as it goes further, it gives more and it takes more. And then what you're going to get? Weaker field outside as it comes through the material. Now play the game of God. Put it in layers. What we call nanolayers. The same property of magnetic field between the atoms, the structure stays, but now it goes between the layers. Call these nanolayers. We know nanolayers are capacitor. For the first time we can show it how, because we explained it and done it before. So the minutest amount of magnetic field from anywhere in the universe going through a nanolayer brings the nanolayer to a capacitor, so you can absorb any kind of energy you like. So look at this. This is a copper wire, and is very much, this is what it is. Somebody told me we gave this piece to the Italian representative in the presentation of 6th of December. Where are you? There he is. He's a very cheeky man. We didn't know who he is, but we know who he is. He says to me, he asked the lady who was here, they send this to Italy to be checked for its quality. He's a scientist from Italy, but it's a part of the EU. Yes, EU scientific group. So we did not give them this. I gave them the key to the secret of universe energy. If they understand it, they can replicate it. Italy will be one of the leading energy producers within a matter of weeks. That's how open we are. That's why we gave the advantage to the governments to understand what is going to hit them. Then you're all going to get it. So if you put this in a very easy way of an 8, you have enough to absorb all the minutest magnetic field in your environment. These are the new power cells. These are the new solar cells you have it on your roof. But the thing is, the difference between this and others is that these new power cells produce more energy at night than the daytime, because the layers have magnetic gravitational field, which they can absorb the radiation coming out of the planet much better than the solar cell coming down. We showed this in Eindhoven, but a lot of people didn't understand it. So we didn't take it that they don't understand it, because you don't know the knowledge. Now we teach you the knowledge. So what happened? This little copper, which has been, this material is a diamond. If you can take this off, the interesting is it'll never come off. It's been measured by Ghent University Professor Van den Bosch. Of the electric. It has the resistance when they are over each other. You can twist it together as much as you like. And the resistance is about 20 mega ohm. It's one of the best resistors they have ever seen. They put current to it. We have videos of it. We can show you. It will not melt. The strange thing, we did one in the lab about 4 years ago. The copper melts, but the tube doesn't melt, and then it takes back the shape of the copper tube again. So if you go back, you see what happens. If you can gather all the energy which is absorbed by this layer, this one is about, we think, between 40 and 50,000 layers. It's not just one layer. To see one nano, you know how much one nano is. We can't see one nano. To see a layer and be so like a diamond, it has to be at least 30,000 layers. But it doesn't come off. I can give it to you, you can rub it as much as you like. Don't eat it. But the beauty of it is, you can, don't eat it, just leave it. You can't eat it. So, you can check it for a smile, it's good for you. It doesn't come off. It's not a painted. Is diamond structure. So what happens, these layers are capacitors. If you can absorb all these minute rays which you saw here and store it, you can run a torch. This principle can be in deep space, can be in your home. The panel less than half a meter by a meter can produce up 3 to 4 kilowatt more at night when you need it than the daytime. We put Keshe power cell, if you pay your PayPal to buy the book, you pay to Keshe power cell technologies. Keshe power cell technologies was set up 3 years ago to produce these systems. And up to 6 months ago, actually we received the BTV number in past 2 weeks. 2 weeks. It took us 3 years to get a permission from the Belgian authorities. They will not issue license. That's how it is. So don't tell us we don't have it, we give you data, you can check. You've been paying Keshe power cell. Keshe power cell was set up by Mr. Declarations to produce this. And now you see how the old meets the new. Tesla wasn't wrong, but Tesla works in a matter level. We do the same thing, universe works on the same basis, but we work in a plasma level. Tesla was ahead of his time, but in a matter level. As I explained to you, you start from the sun, you go through the transition, what we call a dark energy, you like it, we call it transition because it needs time to transmit from one entity to another, and then becomes matter. And Tesla work in a matter level. We work in a plasma level, which means all the energy levels, all the strength of magnetic field from what you call a dark principle, antimatter, to matter and below is available to you. So there is no limitation. And if you want to see, have you ever seen a light of a man? You will see my light. It's very easy. You've been to my shows, you've seen it. This is the same material in a different combination. And most of the light you see, why it's so powerful at the moment, is the energy which is absorbed from my heart and being in my body. This is exactly what you saw here. So, in fact, you receive my light in your eyes and you get my knowledge the same way. If you understood, you don't need to see me. Once you receive my light, you're already enlightened. That's the beauty of it. And that's what we put to man to understand, as what we say here, Keshe Foundation, serving humanity. Knowledge and technology for prosperity and peace. Because from now on, nobody needs to die of hunger and nobody needs to die of cancer. We're bringing scientists who understand the reality and the people who work with the reality, not the people who have to protect a piece of paper, say professor or doctor. So we brought, especially went to Professor Mile because he suffers the same kind of problem as we do with the scientific world, and he's done for years in recognition. And next talk is by Emily, who's in the other end of medical side. We bring the reality of how we are done. And hopefully we see the man, if the American government doesn't put pressure on him, who's been to the moon. Then we can all understand the feeling being, but the difference is we won't experience his experience, because when you create gravitational magnetic fields in a system, you can dictate the atmosphere. So why we all be traveling soon to the moon and Mars and beyond is not that it's a fairy tale, it's just that in our reactors we will be creating the 1G property. Would you like the 1G to be 10 meters or 200 meters? Because you can control the field inside. So we all be traveling immediately, like the way we go to America on a jetliner. It's a false magnetic gravitational field of 1G. Now we have the knowledge, we can do it. And then you can play the game. You create gravitational magnetic field of the poison, you can attract poisons from anywhere. You create magnetic gravitational field of a wood, you can attract and move wood. If you've been on our website, you see we put a plastic on, because plastic is very easy to make. If you see in the video, we make plastic to move through the same principle. Now, the rest of the knowledge is upon you. We teach you bit by bit on a free basis. So it means if this video gets on the net tonight, all the scientists, all the people who want to know, will learn automatically, immediately. And this is how the new teaching will be. There'll be no more peer review, because if you understand it, you don't need somebody else to read the book. It's not the olden time that the priest had to read the Bible and how it suits him, he interpreted it for you. You interpret it your own way. There are people in this room who are rapidly translating the books and everything into any language possible. The book has already been translated to Chinese without us knowing. The German has been done without us knowing. The German version can be bought before Christmas. Most probably all three books within the next 2 to 3 months will be available. I know some people are working on the French. There are some people working on the Flemish. And I know the Iranian versions were the very first one which were done. The Iranians were very rapid to do it. We asked 2 people who have replicated our system to be here tonight. If you go on the website, you know one of him. He announced about 2 months ago that he's replicated it with £3 in England. He's been in touch, but we will show his system because he's copied it, hopefully on the 14th of December. There are German scientists in Germany who's done the plasma technology in motion. So they'll be here the next time as well. Interesting enough, there is an Iranian scientist in Holland, he was here 2 Mondays ago, he has more or less reached the point. We'll most probably have him on the board. UCLA has done the replication, we know because they've sent us the picture of it, and we are ready to transfer full knowledge. But let the government have their time, that they can put things in security safe for you lot, then you can have whatever you like. And that's it. This is the first lesson. You've been a good student, now you can ask questions. No questions? Yes. I was born to a family which radiation is part, was part of life. My father is still alive, but he was part of the structure of Philips International in X-rays in Iran. So in Iran, when you're the first son, daddy takes you everywhere because you got to learn. Doesn't matter, he didn't know or he knew that the radiation is no good for me, but I had to go to the hospitals with him because he was handing over systems of setting up the X-ray machines and all sorts of machines. And that's where the first time started. And now we are here after 40 years. Research has never stopped. I used to even take flight that nobody would talk to me that I could be up there to do my research. Because when you're down here, there is too much pressure. Next question. Do you mind telling me where you come from? At least we know. Yes. No, you haven't seen my reactors. I have one of the most expensive reactors in the universe. Tell you the truth, how much did SCK spend? They spent hundreds of thousands to test our reactor. It was so sophisticated, and they spent nearly 4 months with a budget from Belgium central government budget because SCK couldn't afford it. This is, we show you documents. And they worked very hard to work on our very expensive reactors. Our reactors are actually Coca-Cola bottles. And you believe it or not, Belgium government at SCK, we have report, part of the report is being so diverted not to show what has been developed, that just been, and the thing is, the interesting thing was we went with our lawyers, with our notary, and usually when you want to find budget for research, you have to go and then they decide, they find somebody. Belgium thought this is so stupid that we went in on Monday, we signed a contract with the government and Professor Van der Waal, the director of SCK, not with the SCK lawyer, he wanted to be there because it's a breakthrough. And we signed on a Friday, 5 o'clock in the afternoon, and they wanted the material Monday morning. That's how bad this technology is. So your government has already spent millions on this technology. We have started releasing documents. I went to the Atomic Energy Inspectors 2 weeks ago, and I went with the reports which are supposed to be classified, but it's theirs, they paid for it, they come classified to them. And when you read this report, it's shocking what they are covering up. Discovery of this material was done by IMEC in the report of 2006. And we received a registered letter by IMEC to Keshe Foundation on the 6 paragraphs of law. If I tell to anybody what I've discovered, I can go to prison. This is what it is. And now we are releasing the documents and the papers. We are very open. Peter, can I have the book number 3, please? You have to understand the process here. The process is a peer reviewing. I showed it yesterday to Professor Meyer. By peer reviewing, the control is done. And the people who are peer reviewing, huh? My book yesterday. Yes, I don't lie. You see, in this book, a lot of you who've been to my presentations, you know, in this book, page 151, and we start doing it, there is more of this we're going to publish. Slowly, we decided to publish a lot of things to open up a lot of doors. The title of this paper is The Creation of Black Hole. Dirk Loresen said to me, we have to start publishing the papers, otherwise they block somewhere else. So the only way to do, we do it in a book, nobody needs to peer review it. You read it, you peer review it yourself. This paper, The Creation of Black Hole, was submitted to Royal Astronomical Society in England. Date of the letter goes back to April of 2004, The paper was submitted to say the black holes are not what Mr. Stephen Hawking says, that they absorb everything. Black holes radiate matters and rays, and they're actually a source, they're like a sun. So I received a letter to say that they're going to keep this paper in the library, but they won't publish it. The paper is dated the 7th of July. I received it in the post on the 8th of July. Interesting enough, the eminent scientist, Mr. Stephen Hawking, on 8th of July, you go on the internet, announced that he has changed his mind, the black holes do leak. So, who's peer-reviewing who? And interesting enough, to his stupidity, he has this book and our lawyers in his hand for a year now. He hasn't claimed anything yet. Eminent scientists like this doesn't sit. There are people in this room, in the back. We gave a lecture when this book was published, The Origin of the Universe, on a Friday in Leuven. Yes, it was organized by Guy. There were some 70, 80 people in the room. And out of nowhere, suddenly on a Tuesday, Stephen Hawking appeared in Leuven giving a lecture. You go on the internet. The Origin of the Universe. You just need to check. So, don't rely on peer review, read it yourself. And what we know, and what you heard, and what we're going to teach, is nothing compared to you and your children are going to open up to this knowledge. Last March, we put the seeds around the world in 7 locations, and signed the people. To hear. Is it better now? Is it harder? No, no, we put the seed experiment around the world with 7 locations. We sent packs of seed to 7 different volunteers around the world to grow. World. World, world. In Saudi Arabia, in Germany, Sweden, Belgium, England, America, and Canada. And we had the results back that there is something strange happening with this seed, with the process we developed. I received a call from our head office in Holland. There is a huge box here. Can you come and get it? I said, what is this box? This is heavy. Do you want us to send it by post? I said, whenever I pass, I go. I pick it up. The gentleman in Germany who tested it, he sent us the whole soil and everything back. So I gave the whole package to Guy and said, Guy, have a look at it, because it's his job. He understands this. And then the condition came. Now he's running experiment with other scientists who he can tell you if he likes. And we're testing the seeds. And he has come up with a fantastic ideas, because it's his job, to soak them a little bit more, put them a bit different way. If you want, you can speak to him. And now we see usually one seed, usually gets one stem. With his, we said earlier, gets 6 or 7 stem. It's the job of you and your children to find out how we can harvest this thing, this knowledge. I cannot do everything, and I'm sure all of us, plus all of our great-grandchildren, will not be able to open the whole of this knowledge. So that's why we give the knowledge to the world, and let's see what we do together. And this is what the teaching program is. Yes. Let the Italians ask questions, because they've got our secret in their hand.
What did you do to the seeds? How did you treat the seeds?
The process is very interesting. I wrote about this about 4 years before, 3 years before. But you know, us scientists, we get distracted. We are like little children with different toys. You go into a game shop and you want everything and you get distracted. I got distracted by something else, but I knew this can be done. So we ran an experiment where I knew you can create solid matter out of gas at room temperature. This was, as a nuclear physicist, something very clear to me for past 20 years. But I could not understand the process. The process started actually in Tehran. 4 years ago this time I was in Tehran, so we were running heavy experiments. So I knew I can produce protein out of fresh air. I did it in Tehran. So then I said to one of my colleagues, I can produce gold out of fresh air. He said, Mehran, you're the crazy guy. You do a lot of crazy things, but this is impossible. I said, if I understand physics correctly, somewhere in this reactor, I can create condition that you can create material very much like gold. We run the experiment. The materials are here in Belgium. You don't understand. We were just going through the pictures a few days ago with Dirk to choose what we're going to show in some of our PowerPoints. He picked me up from the airport when I came back in Paris. Nobody knew I was in Iran, and nobody knew I was coming back except Dirk and my wife. And he just put the picture on, says, Mehran, this is when you're coming with the video. I went to Iran with 20 kilos. I came back over 100 kilos. The Iranian scientists, the Iranian government said, this technology is yours. You can do more with what you discovered than we can. They packed all my systems, all the reactors, and said, we have a copy, you can do more. I came back with the most top secret reactors back to this country. What you hear about Iran is not true. So we looked at the pictures, huh? All packed by government for me, make sure nothing gets damaged when I come back. So I knew you can create gold out of thing. I knew you can create protein out of fresh air, but it was one off. I had to find a way nature does it. How does nature transfer gases into solid matter? The answer was there, but I couldn't see them. When I saw it, I knew what I've got and what I've got to do. As I always say, just pinch yourself. Just go like this. Press your meat between two flashes. Your flesh between two fingers. You are pinching four gases, the amino acid, the structure of your body. Our body continuously converts hydrogen, nitrogen, carbon, and oxygen into solid protein. So the process must be very simple. We didn't understand it. So I set out to do it, and it took me less than 3 weeks to do it. Now we can convert all gases into solid matter. We call it in our book GANS. All it is, all goes back to this. It's very simple. If you have an object like this, Earth, proton, we call it different name because we came across a different time. Atmosphere, in a large cell like Earth, we call it atmosphere. Us physicists, we call it Coulomb barrier. And then in a solar system, they call it, what do you call it? It has a very nice name for it. So we call different barriers. Now we have learned in our system to change the strength of this barrier, and now we can control the change of gravitational, because I told you, a matter has to have both to be a matter. One hold on to what it is and one protects. We call it atmosphere, magnetic field. The other one we call it gravity or pulling field. Now, up to now, we knew three states of matter, solid, gas, and liquid, which are environmental dependent. If your temperature goes up, it goes from one to another. Now we learned how to control the gravitational magnetic field. You can have a matter in solid state anywhere in the universe at any temperature. Our body does it. So what happens when you reduce some of this field to become solid property? You have to release some of this magnetic field because it's too much of it. Otherwise you stay in the solid, in the state you were. That release in our body, which is magnetic field, which is getting released continuously to become solid from gases or from in one state to another, is the temperature of our body, 37 degrees. In Eindhoven, we showed it as a light. In Elector laboratory, they ran, when we converted CO2 as a gas to a solid, we ran a motor. They had motors. And the beauty of it is, the more thing you add to the system, you don't need any electronics. The system adjusts itself to the environment, how much it takes from it. It's literally this material. As you put more demand on it, the more it absorbs from its environment. So what it does, if you give it the right condition where life created on Earth, you find out you can create life in a very easy way. And that's very simple, because this is CO2 in liquid, this is CO2 in powder. We don't say it because we gave it before the Belgian government banned the scientists in Belgium to work with us. We gave it to Professor Report, Chemical France Report, in University of Ghent, and they were so interested to get, you understand what I was telling you earlier on about SCK. I put a call to the university because we had a good relationship. I said, we discovered something new. We needed to be Raman spectroscopy, infrared spectroscopy, any spectroscopy. We want to know what this material is. Usually takes weeks if you can find a scientist. We had such a good relationship report from inside the university. They told me, I said to my wife, if they give us time, April, May, was just before Christmas, we are lucky. He said, 4 o'clock in the afternoon, doctors are ready to test everything for you. Immediately, they did all these graphs, Raman spectroscopy, infrared, is done by them, it's their report. And then immediately got classified, because this cannot come out. This material is the most beautiful superconductor ever known to man. We put it on the machine, the computer went on, was one is 14 different elements, which some of it are known to man, and some of them is 22 different elements unknown to man. Because these materials are the most beautiful superconductors we ever know. In a way, that's how our body works. I was just explaining to Emily, if you watch, I was talking to her all the time during the talk of Professor Miles, I was trying to explain to him. A lot of people think all the information done through neurosystem. No, we've proven it to our medical side. You feel in your brain, your toe picks up. You don't need connection. This is how we create our own cancer. We feel the pain. We create a specific magnetic gravitational field which changes some cells' structure. We give it too much. Instead of being one solid, it becomes something else. It's the process of cancer. It's a process. We create most of our diseases through our own emotion. Yeah? So, Professor Miles shows it through this. Tesla showed it through the same way. Now we understand the operation of the plasma. We understand how it works. So, you want to see liquid CO2? We don't say it. Actually, if you look at this, you see all the marks. You've been to my lectures, you know, all the black marks are from our friends in Canada when they captured me and imprisoned me for 11 days. To steal. And you understand the influence of this foundation. We are one of the most influential scientific organizations. The last time we gave a talk on the 21st, on 23rd, it was a special decree against, in a way, cover of Keshe Foundation, because in that presentation I showed how the American planes captured. And for the first time, 3 days ago, we put a video on the internet. We showed for the first time how the plane is captured. You can go on the internet and see it. And we had a presentation on the 6th of September here last Thursday. Friday morning, Canadians were the only ones which were not invited. Friday morning, they closed the Iranian embassy in Canada, and the same, they called ambassadors back. So, and at the same time from that presentation, the president of Sudan announced the establishment or wanting to establish the African Space Agency, because they asked us, can we have it? And the other one says, can we have it? Now we're going to see who's going to have it. They're all going to have it together. Yeah? So it's very simple to create matter as you need. Now we know the gravitational magnetic field. In reality, it's very easy. All you need to do is change the size of these holes. This is what we are looking now. I'm going to Africa and hopefully we get the permission to do it. The normal red blood cells is 10 micron or whatever it is. 8 is 11. So it's just a slightly bigger. We don't have that kind of filter. But we have nanomaterial filters. And nanomaterial filters are these. And I've just bought a system to be able to produce this like a blood vessels. All you need to do, just like a dialysis machine, allow the blood to flow at a rate which only the bigger than the blood cells of red blood cells can go through. There are complications which we have to understand. you have different elements and matters in the body, you have to let them go through, or you create a gravitational magnetic field of the aids, which is the research to be done, and then you can extract it out. Either way, you can do it easier way. So the nano filters is actually what we done for 5 or 6 years ago. He was present. We were doing an interview a couple of nights ago here, the cameraman, because he was appointed by them to do it. The gentleman who was interviewing on the other end, he asked me, do you know MIT speaks about the filter to clean oil from the, you know, like Mexican Gulf and the rest? This patent was offered and is sitting in the European and world patent. When did we put a CO2 patent in Turk, the nano? 2007. The CO2. 2002 patents for filtering through nanomaterial and gravitational magnetic property of the CO2 is already in. But part of the nanomaterial unknowingly is in the patent number one in the first 40 claims. It's in there, but if you read it, you understand it. So you can create it, creating, producing these solar cells, what do you call it, roof cells, should cost between 100 to 120 euros. But the beauty of it is you do not need the storage and you do not to give it to the government. You take as you like.
Talking about generators, you have been given the possibility to reserve power generators.
Whoever has applied for it by this Christmas will get it. And from next week it's going to be stopped.
And there is no, let's say, blockage as you call?
The only blockage is if they put me in prison or something else happens by accident again, huh?
But listen, so the power generators have been built already?
We don't talk. The thing is, we build it up. If I give you the generators, your government's block you bring it in is no use. And this is what it sits at the moment. You have to understand. You see half of the story. I hear the other half through other channels.
You cannot deliver on the spot, so where they are?
No. Read your contract. We tell you where it is. Shipping is your problem, not mine. Yeah. You know. And the thing is, we tell your government. You bought. Don't forget, all our emails are public knowledge. So, as you know, you're in the government. You see everything I do. So very easily, they know who has paid for it. And all the deposits is in the bank account in Holland, that if we fail, you get your money back. But we brought this position up, and the situation with Africa is going on so rapidly in South America, to stop those kind of blockages. But I will report, it's part of the Keshe Foundation policy, we report to your government you bought one and you're shipping. This is our law. This is the way you have to handle it.
But not everyone in the government is bad.
No. We are working with your government because once you bring the system in, once 1 million, 2 million supplied in Belgium, so much revenue goes out of the government. Then you have to find a way to tax them. We are telling the government that was the whole purpose of governmental meeting. Yeah, this is what's coming. You're going to get hit. Think about it.
So I just wanted to say for the benefit of everybody that whoever wants to stop something, it's always the numbers they have are much less than us. So the people who want progress is much more. We have many more. There are very few. So don't get scared.
We are not. If I was scared, I wouldn't be here. Yeah, the thing is, it shouldn't be scaring. It should be collaboration. The time of fighting is finished. The fight, I don't fight anymore.
But we understand. Yeah. On the other side, maybe they don't.
No. They come to understand. Do you know what is strange? We run every Monday medical sessions here. I see a lot of medical people who come. They're all osteopath, or they know somebody, or they send their patients here. I was surprised 4, 5, 6 weeks ago, a paralyzed guy turned up from Turkey here. And I said, how did you hear about us? Our doctor in Ankara told me that you're the only person who can get me walking in a village. And he's here. And now he's moving. We asked I asked a gentleman who is an ILS, people here know him, he comes here walking. He should have been paralyzed totally. According to the ILS committee, American committee here in Belgium, he should have been dead. But he's still walking. Now, he was walking very nicely a few weeks ago. We dropped him on the front door. He got excited going out. And now, he used to be on braces. The braces are off, so they slow down till the drop foot sorts itself out. So, we try all sorts of things. We don't say no to you. A lot of people say, €5,000 for a generator is too expensive. I say, €20,000 for a sunroof is very cheap. Buy that one. You understand? And then they say, if you got it so cheap, why not? Why don't you give it to us? It's our right to have free. It's your right to have it free. It's your stupidity because my patents are there. Go and make it. You don't need to pay me $5,000. You understand? We have opened it. There are people who are replicating it. But they say energy. Energy is not none of my concern. Energy is a byproduct. I create a plasma. The plasma releases part of its magnetic field. I capture it and it's the torch. That's all it is. Now we open the plasma, we can do it easier. We had a huge development in past 2 or 3 months because I understood something which I didn't understand for 40 years. And I immediately put into action to confirm the development. And part of it is this. Part of it is this. Because there is a huge part of information which was missing for me for 40 years. And it just came to me. It was sitting there for years, but I couldn't see it. It came out of the experiment in Tehran. I saw it, I couldn't understand it. And then it came out of the Mahdis Jalali of Iranian government. He said, Mehran, for this we should make so much things, make a reactor, we can put it in a generator. We forget about everything else. So I went and I built a coil in a specific combination done by a friend here in Belgium. And I started generating energy. I thought this is the one, we're going to put it out. But now I understand you can do it for about $25 in an easier way. Next question.
I'm from Frankfurt, Germany.
Yes.
And my question concerns your technology in general.
In what?
In general.
Yeah.
My understanding, there is a connection between the development of the technology in the world and between the development of the human consciousness. And so, in my opinion, there cannot be over unity technologies without a unity in thinking of the person, of the people.
This is what I say, that once we give people this knowledge, at the beginning it'll be mayhem, if you've been in my presentations. It'll be like a man who's lived in a box or in a room for years and then he wins $100 million lottery. He goes crazy, he buys everything he can. And then he gets to the point he gets tired of going shopping because he's bought everything. And he's still got another 90 million. Then, now there's become famous, they call them philanthropists. He tries to give a little bit to the neighbor because I've got too much, he gets ashamed of what he has. When this technology will come out, there'll be the same process. Everybody wants to have everything. Oh, I have a golden car, I have 2 flying machines, and I have 10 of this. And then they get tired because the neighbor has the same and everybody else, there is no pride in having. Then the pride becomes in serving. My neighbor doesn't, he's ill, huh? Nothing can be done, I look after him. I try to contribute. And then that's where the unity comes. At the beginning it'll be mayhem, I can see it. I already have seen mayhem in past 2 weeks with the government. The shuffling, the mayhem has come in Keshe Foundation recently. In positioning themselves. Because now suddenly we are opening, they are pushing each other, well, I'm better. And I stand there and say, stupid. Everything is there. You can't control it. I stay in control till when you all become children, understanding what you all have the same, then we run the whole thing in one go. I see it, it'll repeat. It has happened and it will happen. It'll be absolute chaos after 21st of December. After 14th of December, it'll be worse, because everybody wants to go to moon. Everybody wants to fly to London tomorrow, and you get all the Chinese in front of Washington, and you get all the Africans sitting in front of London. They want to see the Queen, and it's not good enough, because the Queen has taken for 200, 300 years everything they had. So they go in the palace, they take everything. So the government has to stop this mayhem. That's why we talk to the government. You've seen how simply I explained the knowledge on the edge to you in 1 hour. In the past, for any of you to receive this knowledge would have taken 50, 60, 100 years if they would have allowed to know it. Yeah? We make the knowledge free and we start showing you things in reality. There are people in this room who have been touched by the Keshe Foundation technology. The first one is here. This gentleman, Mr. Declarescence, he can tell you. He had a stroke. He's done all the work of the pictures of the foundation. Total, you can show them, your hand. This hand was paralyzed, and this hand now writes all the pictures and does all the things for you. We have knowledge. There are people in this room who can tell you how we changed their life. Yeah? By just drinking water. Huh? But the problem is, if you release all this technology in one go, the pharmaceuticals get damaged. We don't want anything there to go wrong, because the whole lot of you get the wrong pill, they kill the whole lot of you. Or we don't want to damage the oil industry, because the oil creates a lot of revenue. So the governments have to find a new way of us contributing to running of our own society. And it will come very soon. The mayhem will follow with a beautiful peace, but I can see the end in 12 months, 18 months. But till we get there, the ride will be very rough, believe you me. That's why we concentrate on Africa very heavily, to bring Africa in a level they don't need to come here. When they have it, we stop the migration. You find all the Americans would like to go to Africa, because Africa has more than they have. It goes reverse. So we have to carry the governments, we have to carry the people at the same time. And your impatience doesn't change my decision. We go the way we are going.
Did I hear you correctly that you said sometime in the future, there will be this place of Venus will be taken by the Earth.
Yes.
Are we talking about millions, billions?
It's millions of years. Because what happened, we didn't understand this originally. It came out of an experiment. If you look at some of the reactors which you see it on our books sometimes, just let me put this. Can you secure this? Thanks. If you look at the book, some of our books, we have pictures. These pictures are not fairy tales. These are actually reactors which we run. In these reactors, you see windows. We see structures in the universe in these reactors. We have a window, we see it. Our original reactors, we've always been taught plasma is very hot and it destroys things and it's heat temperature. This reactor was second, third generation. And this is a steel, a stainless steel. And it took us how long? 4 or 5 months? They looked everywhere, and it was built in Holland at the end of it. This stainless steel, because we thought it's temperature. If you look at the new generation reactors, even the ones which came from Iran with me, it's all plastic. Body operates, creates its own gravitational magnetic field in the skin of a man, so you don't need to have a heavy things. So what's the next step? You tell me. Question. You start answering yourself, and then we have no more problem.
How many times do I have to take a lecture, and what kind of support can I expect when I want to rebuild one of these stainless steel or plastic reactors using your knowledge? What do I have to do?
You go home, you go on European pattern, you download the pattern. Reading it is not important. Understand the way I write it, not the way you like to read it. This is a big difference. No, I can teach you till 1 million years, you won't understand it, so you say it cannot be built. Strange enough, I was telling I would like to thank him, he's inside, he'll look after us later on. The catering staff here are Iranians, totally by chance. I never knew they existed till about 6 months ago, but He looks after us very well. And I was just telling him, strange enough, most of the people who have replicated my systems are Iranian scientists. I said to him, I think I write it Iranian English, that's why they understand better. Huh? So if you understand me, you can copy it.
I watched your interview on the internet, and you told that somebody skilled in his arts will be able to replicate it if he has read book 1 to 4, but it's dangerous for people who have not the qualification because it's...
The danger is because I've been there. The danger is you are releasing. You do not understand what we say. You are unleashing a power which we do not, most of us, know. I have bought a machine for 10,000 euro and I had to wait 6 months for it to be set. It had to be sent to a special hospital in Switzerland that they could put in an MRI system. I was explaining to Dirk recently that they could measure the minutest radiation in the three-dimensional environment before I get it. Because when I was in Tehran 4 years ago, I'm a stupid scientist. If you know, all the scientists die of their own system or their own technology. I created so much field around me. When I came back from Tehran, he can tell you, there was a suspected cancer of pancreas and liver. So it's better to leave it in the hand of the people to know at least at the beginning, and then you start replicating it. We don't know how. You see, this material I gave you, I showed you, is fantastic to see CO2 in a powder or liquid. A strange thing with it is, I don't let you touch it, not because I'm jealous, because the minute I touch it, I taste it. We don't know the property of it. It's the job of the scientist to find out. The information transfer is so rapid, it doesn't need my neural system. It's instantaneous. We don't give technology out just not to give you, because we don't know ourselves. It's a beginning. It's the same thing with the seed. I asked from Guy, get the seeds, where bodies harvest, even one seed, to the scientists in the university, see if it's genetically changed. Or is it the same seed? You are at the beginning of a breakthrough in science. We don't know. I advise you, don't make it. Don't get anxious. Let us develop it. Let us scientists to do it. Then in time we pass it on. We give the you the gift of life free. It's you to choose it, to use it. A lady came here, a dentist, 37 years old, breast cancer, 7 months ago, Kristen, 6-7 months ago, she came to see us in an old place. She said, I have cancer, I'm going to die in Leuven University here in Belgium. They made a mistake. They left part of the cancer tumor in the breast. When she went to do the refilling, they found another piece of cancer. And the plan was not to put the silicone, but to get the fat from the back and fill it as a natural way in the breast. So they cut the breast with the same knife with the cancer as the back, so immediately the cancer was transferred to the back and the bone. And I said to her, she attended 2 of our presentations, and she said, can you help me? I built a machine for her, and I gave her the machine free. With cancer, we don't charge anymore, because we realize when you have on the death line, you do anything, you pay anything. So our cancer units are totally free. It cost us 100, 200,000, it cost me. My wife can tell you, I work 3-4 o'clock in the lab. I wake up 1 o'clock in the morning to make sure cancer has a priority. And then we gave this machine free to her. 2 weeks later, she called me and says, I want to give the machines back. I found a doctor in Germany, a Chinese, who with herbs can cure me. I said, no problem, I'll have it back. 82,000 euro cost. I took it back. Last Friday, we were going out. She called me on the phone. The cancer has come back very bad in the lining of the stomach. Yeah, cavity of the thing, because she used a specific word. I didn't know what it means in Flemish. I asked Caroline, can you translate it for me? I said, Monday morning, I usually come here at 10 o'clock, be here 9. I build you a new system because we discovered something new. We can stop cancer. We have that knowledge now. It's known. We can reverse and stop any kind of cancer. So I said, come here Monday morning, I'll build you a system. I spent Monday morning, about 3 o'clock in the morning, I spent a lot of time building a special system from the new knowledge. I came Sunday afternoon, we were at the coast, she called, she says, the pain is so much, I've come to the hospital. I can't come, can you come back to me on Tuesday when I come out of the hospital? I called Tuesday, I couldn't get her, I called Wednesday 10 times. On the father's phone, he's a dentist, he picked the phone up and he says she's dead. She died Monday night. 128,000 euros of system in the bin. Research organizations cannot take these kind of losses, but we are committed, we do. It's not a joke, we give it to you. We have a lot of people who come here with a lot of problems, they think we are God. We are not God, we just manipulate the structure of the plasma the way we understand. We have people who've been in cancer, the people who've been 4 or 5 years paralyzed, they come here and they walk after a few months, or at least they become mobile. We don't understand the whole structure. We are at the beginning of a very long process. What we understand, we do. The computer guys will put from, I don't know if it's gone on or it goes, fibromyalgia, we have found the solution for fibromyalgia 100%. So from now, you will see in this week on the Keshe Foundation, we want 100 people in one go. We take 100 fibromyalgia people around the world, and we run 3 months, 6 months, we think 95% of them can be reversed totally by themselves. And then in July, August next year, we do 1,000 trials. Because then you validate your technology, what it is.
Did I understand right that you made major progress recently on cancer?
Yes. Well, the thing is, I was just explaining to our new health director, she will take over very soon one day, that the process of cancer and bone marrow starts in the stomach. This is something new. I built a unit. Actually, the discussion came with Yvonne. He's a dentist here. He explained to me something 6 months, 8 months ago, and I thought it makes sense, but I have to see it. So I followed it in different part of research and development, and I made a unit. I'll bring it on Monday. You'll be surprised what it is. To show that the bone is not what we think. Bone is a filter. Then you can play the game of God with your body in your stomach, not in the bone marrow. What would you like to suck in to become your factor 4 or T4 or B cells? That is not done in the bone. It's the source of it sits in your stomach in what you eat. So through that and the operation of control of cancer, cancer is a lump. When you become solid, you have a little tumor, what do you call it? Gland in just about here that controls the size of the solidity of the matter in your body. So when you can control the stomach with this gland, that's why it's here. Nobody knows why thymus is here. Yeah, it's here not because it happened to be here. It's here because it controls before the thing goes to the body what it needs to be produced as a bone marrow, that it comes up, that it within a B12 inside it can divide it. This sits here for it's a control between the mouth, the brain, and the stomach. That's his job. Now we understand it, so we can control what goes solid when and where. So if you can stop a cell becoming cancer to last longer, you produce or change it. We have a breast which has been donated to us by a woman who died. We analyze it, we understand it. So now we think more or less you can do a lot of things with cancer. We stop the cancer for 4 months, within 3-4 months we didn't do any cancer. Now we start looking because now we are, I do things, when I don't understand, I stop. 6 months, 12 months, 10 years later I come back to it when I understand it. So now we understand cancer, we can be done. And it's controlled through your stomach and your thymus, and that's it. That's why we do so well in our space technology. NASA has to plan to go to Mars 30 years, 40 years ahead. They have to plan everything. Because in the process of NASA, they have to fight everything. They have to fight the gravity, they have to fight diseases in the cell, they have to have enough food to take. For me, which I understand, the proportionality is just a matter of what you call it, proton, electron, or the same thing as a sun. I have the best galaxy and a space technology in my hand. It's called the human body. So I don't need to spend billions to go to understand the operation between that and that. So I know, they say I do miracles, I get the people walking, or the people have no feelings in their toe. No. All we do, we put a helmet here and we put a shoe there. I bypass the neural system. Ooh. We don't want nobody to know. Yeah, no problem. So I don't need to, I bypass the neural system. I make a connection between the two. When the process is done, you don't need to waste time in the middle. And then the neural system follows it. That's it. So I don't need to spend billions to understand what will happen here if I do something on Mars. Earth is here, call it the Moon, call it Jupiter. I want to change things in between. Different organs, it's different galaxies in the same universe. That's all. We have to change our attitude of everything needs a scientist to explain to us. Look within yourself, the answer sits in there. But you've got to look in the right place. You're the best physicist, you're the best doctor, you're the best chemist. But you have to understand what you want to do.
You mentioned some time ago about this committee in Belgium that has to decide about the giving you a license to do something.
If you give me an interview, I'll come tomorrow.
Yeah, yeah. No, no, I want to know, why don't you, let's say, publish on your website the names of these people?
Amongst you here today, without a doubt, there is somebody from Belgium security. We know it. In every meeting, they turn up. My question to them and to the Belgian authorities or any government is, you're welcome. They have to be here. If I use my knowledge slightly in the wrong way, the beautiful machine which gives you life can kill you within seconds. We patent it. We put in our patent how you can kill somebody within milliseconds. As much as I can absorb radiation from environment, I can put radiation in the environment without anybody knowing. I warned this on my one of my outputs in my Odica forums. In Belgium, my wife is Belgian. We were invited here as a guest and there was a plan to block us from developing. It took me 7 years to get work permit, which I've been living in the EU for 39 years. I don't need a work permit, but the political game which was played. And when we opened the book, we were threatened, my wife, in front of my wife, I'll be killed by the top people in this country. Without doubt, they gave her a piece of paper, they're going to kill you. So, we are not afraid, but understand, we are not scared either. They need us because their own children will have cancer tomorrow. Their own wife and themselves will end up with prostate and breast cancer. There is no cure, there is no solution. Come to Keshe Foundation, they turn up. But you have to have respect, and the respect is mutual. You see, when they arrested me on the board of a plane on the 8th of June, 2 years ago, the first thing they told me in front of my sister, we're going to kill him. If you report to any newspaper, he's been arrested on board. They interrogated me for 4 days, up to 18, 20 hours a day. You saw the writing, and the black writing is the Canadian scientists who went through my documents. They kept me for 11 days, and on the 11th day, it was a Saturday, I was told I'm getting deported, because he says to me, the Americans, the British, the Belgium, and the French have decided I'm going back to Belgium. I was on the way to Mexico City for the disaster. When I went down to get my suitcases, I was happy I'm coming back because I was on a death threat by the Canadian government. My prison keepers, they told me, you're not going anywhere. I said, I've already been through the kangaroo court. They have a court in the prison, and they sent me in front of a judge, and they told me, if you tell the judge why we are keeping you here, you come out, you're dead. So I went there, the judge said, blah, 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 we deport you, you're going. I said, yeah. Next time we paid $5,500 for a lawyer to come and sit there and listen to the threats. And he went, we paid the $5,500. And then I went down to my prison keeper, say, I've been told I'm leaving 2 o'clock to Belgium. The guy said, if you're leaving, we get a notice 7 days before. There is nothing here. The guy who came the day before to tell me to be ready, I'm going back on Saturday, he gave me a number. He said, if any problem, call me. I called him, I said, I've been down, I put my suit on, I'm ready, my suitcases are ready in the locker room. They tell me there is nothing, I have to get ready, it's a mistake. He said, I'm coming with your deportation signed by the Prime Minister of Canada. No talk. They came in, full bodyguard, 8 police officers in Toronto Airport, they put me on a plane. If a Prime Minister of government needs to sign my deportation, I must be that important. I put the shit out of some people. But on the other hand, they know they need me, otherwise they would have killed me. Yeah? It's the same in Belgium. There is no difference. There is the same, there is just the scale of the job. The thing is, if you allow us to teach and your government allows us, my trip to China was cancelled because the group which invited me, they couldn't guarantee my security in the airport. So we cancelled it. If you can guarantee our security, we come in and we teach very openly. And it's done by people, through the people, among the people. That's the problem. The Italians got hold of the email of their embassy through our list and they bombarded their government. Literally bombarded it. She had to come because she had to give an answer what happened that day. That's how they knew. Government don't see us as a threat. Government listen to the United States government, how they're going to treat us and what they have to do till the Americans say. I always say the problem with me is not my technology. Is the color of my passport. I lived in Europe for 38, 9 years, and I'm still Iranian national. I don't see why I should change my nationality, but I still stay loyal to the nation I work with and I stay in. So it's their problem to change their mentality. You see, the interesting thing is we had a meeting here last week with ambassadors, and I received, I think I sent it to Peter because he's one of the webmasters. Already in World Press, there is a release that there is going to be technology release in Africa, and the whole thing has been put on in French. And we already see the embassies of Sierra Leone are getting contacted, bombarded by people from other nations. We are coming. We were supposed to have Saudi royal family here today, and they said, we don't come to Belgium, we meet you in Kinshasa, in what do you call it, Sierra Leone, in Freetown, because it's nice and warm there now. Huh? So it's the way, it's because I'm prepared to travel, people are not prepared to come so far. And I thank you, you came from all over the world, from God knows, South America to Australia. The thing is, take the message back. Technology belongs to you, not to us. But use it the safe way. Thank you very much for coming. I hope we can work together in one way or another. And the other thing is, we would like to ask you if you allow us to pass your emails which you registered through to the other people in this forum, that you can build a link together around the world. If that's okay with you, unless you don't tell us no or don't ask the lady at the front, within the next couple of days, we'll let you all have each other's email that you can build the Keshe Foundation universally. Thank you very much.